So, when you open the scene, you will see such basic hair cards, which can work for any hairstyle. The project folder has all the textures for the Unreal Engine. Albedo map, alpha map, Daskid map. The one I usually use is for easy placement of hair cards in Maya. Flow map, gradient map, which can be useful for custom shader, height map, normal map, hour map, random hair map, RGB, which is also a useful map for custom shader, U-gradient map, which can be used for ID, and a root map. In general, all the maps you need to work in UE and not only in it. And the most important thing about the scene is that I've already converted them to hair cards. You can make your own mesh if you need to. These are the hair cards I use to create this hairstyle. Now, let's talk about how you can use this scene. There is already a scalp here, or you can upload your own. You can apply a furball preset to it. Or start drawing guides right away. That is, with Draw Strand tool, you can draw any guides. Any length can be drawn. The texture will adapt in length. The only nuance I want to remind you of. In Maya, there is no branching. Therefore, for each hair group, I create a separate object. That is, select the entire Ornatrix object and use duplicate special. In the end, you will have a complete copy with all the nodes, for which you can use another group of hair cards. This is about workflow in Maya. To turn the guides into hair cards, apply mesh form strands, and in its settings, select proxy. And using the Add Proxy Meshes button, you can choose the right hair card to make it convenient to choose them. Split the viewport into two parts. And for the second part, select front view. Next, turn off the grid and press 6 to display the textures. Now, you can select a proxy and mesh form strands. Then, we assign the hair text material to the Ornatrix object. If any of the hair cards are looking the wrong way, you can select it and rotate it. You can also use Create to create new hair cards. Except you have to draw them in the second edit guides to interpolate the form. Next, using Rotate, correct the wrong direction of some hair cards. It is clear that these intersections can be corrected. But I want to show another point. Many people worry about what will happen if you do very long hair. I'll give you a quick example. And as you can see, the texture is okay. For flyaway hair, you can use the latest proxy. A hair that can be seen from any angle. To prepare your hair for export, select the topmost modifier and delete the history. Then, we drag the resulting object into the outliner. Next, do freeze and reset transformation and delete by type history. After that, press 3 to smooth out all the edges. Next, go to modify, convert smooth mesh preview to polygons. In the end, you get a lot of polygons that need to be optimized. So, we delete the history and we do reduce. In the window that appears, adjust the number of triangles. For example, I want 5000. After you have entered the desired number, press reduce. In the end, you get an optimized mesh. Try to pick up such a number so that the form is not strongly destroyed. Then, delete the history again. And that's it. We have a finished object to export to Unreal with 5,000 triangles. By the way, if there are no bends in the hair card, there is maximum optimization and it is very cool. I think you noticed that the texture disappeared and the object turned green. But if it reassigned, it'll be okay. That's all I wanted to show. Thank you for watching, and I wish you a good mood.